Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'll be your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we're answering the very scary question, what if 20 million trees burn down? Now, before we get into it, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification so you never miss a video. Also, drop us some comments below with some other questions you may have for us. I got some comment replies coming at you at the end of this one, but for now, we gotta talk about trees. If you guys haven't seen our video, what if we planted 20 million trees? Be sure to check that out after this one. We're now looking at the other side of things, and as I'm sure you can imagine, planting 20 million trees is much more beneficial than burning down 20 million trees. Doesn't take a genius to figure that one out. But let's further explore this idea and see how the impact would affect us and who else it would affect. Now, as is the case in almost every video we do here, location is a huge factor. Would 20 million trees in the Amazon rainforest burn down? Or are we talking 20 million trees in a California wildfire? Ultimately, they're both a very sad reality. This past year's forest fires have been quite devastating. And regardless of where it's happening, not much good can come from it. But I think we could do this video speaking in a somewhat general way. Location matters when we get into specifics, such as if farmlands would be affected, if indigenous tribes would lose their homes, and how likely it would be for the fire to spread. For example, in the Amazon rainforest, well, unfortunately, all of that deemed to be true. Whereas in California, there isn't as much farmland, but people have lost electricity as well as their homes due to the fires. Either way, unfortunately, it seems regardless of where the trees burn, millions of people, animals, and species in general are affected. So let's say 20 million trees do in fact burn down. Well, what happens? Do we lose a substantial amount of oxygen? Well, we definitely wouldn't gain oxygen, that's for sure. But we wouldn't even lose 1% of the Earth's oxygen. Although trees produce oxygen, the ocean actually produces half of Earth's oxygen. More specifically, tiny ocean plants called phytoplankton, which lives near the water's surface and drifts with the currents. These little plants produce close to half the Earth's oxygen through photosynthesis, so we wouldn't lose a ton of oxygen, which is the good news. The bad news is that we have a bunch of trees which have burned down. This means a ton of carbon dioxide has been released into the air, which is definitely bad for the environment and will expedite the process of climate change, something we're already having a hard time combating. But we also need to talk about those who actually call these trees home. Birds, rodents, insects, wild animals in general would all be affected. Of course, there would most definitely be a loss of life when it comes to the wildlife, either from being burned or smoke inhalation. Some would of course be able to fly or run away from the fires, while others unfortunately wouldn't be so lucky. A prime example would be the photos that were going viral during the Amazon rainforest fires that happened just a few months ago. And as sad as they were to see, it was the unfortunate reality for thousands of different species. Although 20 million trees seems like a lot, which, let's be honest, that is a lot of trees, it may not affect humans as much as we would believe. It's quite possible 20 million trees burning down could take down an entire forest or park, depending on its size. But with that being said, it's believed as many as 3.5 billion to 7 billion trees are cut down worldwide each year. In comparison, 20 million isn't all that much, but those trees are cut down, not burned down. The major difference there is how the burning down may affect the surrounding areas, as previously mentioned. The burning of trees can also affect the area many years later. The ground where these trees once were wouldn't be the same by any means. And of course, other trees that aren't burned down but are affected by said fire would also be at risk of dying much earlier than they would if there was no fire at all. The loss of trees can also affect the weather. As mentioned in the video we did about planting 20 million trees, these trees can help stop harsh winds in the cooler months or block the sun and provide shade in the warmer months. In areas like the Amazon, they keep the air moist and actually help create the rain clouds that helps the Amazon rainforest thrive. If 20 million trees were to be burned down, well, it may not even be 1% of the hundreds of billions of trees that are a part of the Amazon rainforest, but it would still be 20 million trees less than we previously had. Another factor is the type of trees that would be burned down. Some would definitely release more carbon into the air than others would. Some create much more oxygen than others, and some provide better homes for animals or can be used for medicine. Others will provide fruits or nuts. There are so many variables we can look at when talking about the impact burning down 20 million trees would have. But the reality is, unless you're living remotely close to the area where the trees are burning down, you most likely wouldn't be affected by it much, at least immediately. Now, that's not to say you shouldn't be concerned, because everything does have a chain reaction. An example would be the recent Amazon rainforest fires that were man-made to clear room for farming. It happens every year, but this year was quite severe. Aside from the indigenous tribes that lost their homes and feared for their lives, we lost tons of trees that can provide life-changing medicine. There are hundreds of millions of plant species in the Amazon rainforest, and many believe one of those species can hold the cure to cancer. Others can be used to cure addictions like smoking, cigarettes, or alcoholism, and some can be used to treat anxiety. As you can see, there is such a wide range of benefits trees in the Amazon rainforest alone bring us. And aside from that, we're having a very tough time controlling climate change. So anything that's going to make it harder for us is definitely not a good thing. In this case, 20 million trees burning down releases tons of carbon dioxide into the air, and well, I'm not a scientist, but that's definitely not good for us or the environment, and it wouldn't happen all at once either. As the the trees rot over the years, the carbon dioxide would slowly be released, meaning it would affect our planet for many years down the line. All in all, I think it's safe to say if 20 million trees were to burn down, although you personally might not see the effects immediately, it would impact the world one way or another. Whether it affects your family or friends who are living out there or near the trees, or you rely on medicines that come from the Amazon rainforest, for example, or you eat fruits or nuts that come from the trees, they're certainly essential for our planet and us as humans in general. And that's why it's so amazing that Mr. Beast and the YouTube community are coming together to plant 20 million trees. Now, if you guys have no idea what I'm talking about, be sure to go watch our video, What If We Plant 20 Million Trees? We'll be leaving the link to donate in the description down below. And if you guys can't donate, at the very, very least, I would say ask a friend, family member, teacher, coworker, whoever, to donate even a dollar if possible. Every dollar plants a tree, and that's a positive change. Make sure to share this video with them as well so they have a better understanding of why it's so important. Speaking on that video, let's reply to some comments from it. SSJ Rose said, "This is awesome. I hope next year there is a ocean cleaning campaign. That would be incredible if every year we just do something to make the world a better place. I definitely support that and back it, and hopefully, yeah, maybe next year they can do like an ocean cleaning campaign. That'd be really cool." Marlon Johnson said, "Next one, do babies understand each other?" That's actually crazy. I'm gonna say no. Maybe body language, but they say like you don't even fully understand anything until I think the age of 3 or something. Like sight and smell and feeling, like there's like a certain age that the threshold breaks that you don't understand anything. But I think another cool question would be like, do dogs understand each other? Because physicality and barking, like, is that their language, barking? Like, we assume language is the way we talk to each other, but, you know, growling for a dog means, like, back away, it's mine, right? So it's all body language, I guess. So I feel like babies possibly understand each other, I don't know. Sophia Gonzalez said, "You better donate that money, boy." So in that video, I actually said for every like, I will donate a dollar if I can. The video is now at 10,000 likes, and I can tell you guys right now, I definitely do not have $10,000 to donate, but I will be donating some money. Probably $10, because I have a lot of debt to pay off. But I'm still doing my part and doing what I can. It's not about how much money you donate, it's just about raising awareness and donating what you can. Unfortunately, I definitely cannot donate $10,000 because, like I said, I don't have that much money. I wish I did, and if I did, I would donate the money, but I physically don't even have that amount in my bank account right now, so it's not a possibility. But I do appreciate all your support, guys, and I certainly hope you guys all donate even a dollar if you can, or at least share the video with a friend to raise awareness. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. Make sure you guys subscribe and click that bell, and of course, we'll see you guys in the next one.